Richard just said he wants to try the jump.
Well, rather them than me, but very bravely out on the Skycity walk there in the centre of Auckland. Some of the players yesterday. Really was a glorious day as well. It's been a pretty good afternoon here inside this North Shore Centre as well. And this is our final semi-final for you. It's the men's doubles.
Would you please welcome
by the Indonesian pair here.
In the men's doubles from Indonesia. Fajar Alfian and Rian Ardianto.
Yeah, looking for a third win of 2015, this Indonesian pair.
And the number six seeds from Malaysia. Would you please welcome Hoon Thien Hao and Lim Kim Wah from Malaysia.
Yeah, last Malaysians left in the tournament. Great win for them yesterday, beating Lee and Liu, who won a couple of weeks ago at the China Masters, World Junior Champions. So should be an interesting matchup this. Obviously not met. It's a fairly new partnership. Here's the Malaysian pair Lim and Hoon. Whereas Fajar Alfian Mohamed, Rian Ardianto, they've been in good form. I said a couple of wins, albeit at tournaments that are, I suppose, a lesser level than the one we're seeing here this week.
Yeah, they've certainly been in good form. So far, they've had a couple of three-set wins, but also tend to worked their way into the match and been able to turn it around after having dropped the first set on a couple of occasions.
Lim Kim Hwa there nearest to us. And won a Super Series event last year with Govi Shem. Not quite a Scotch partnership, but they've just their second real test. This they played in the China Masters a couple of weeks ago. That's Hoon Tien Hao, and they did okay there. Although, having said that, as you can see, this is their win-loss ratio prior, obviously, to this week. But they had played together back in an event in 2010, the Malaysian Open, and they went down fighting against a certain partnership of Marcus Kido and Hendra Setiawan, but it's taken them a little while to rekindle things. They're now independent shuttlers, not part of the Badminton Association of Malaysia, despite their ranking of 257, because of course this is only their really second event. They are seeded number six. Let's hear what they have to say about things.
Men's semi-final, Hoon Tien Hao and Lim Kim Hwa. Well, let's start with you. Hoon, six plays seven. This promises to be a very tight semi-final.
Kita pun tak fikir apa lah. Kita cuma fikir kita sendiri main game. Kita prepare lah.
Right, so they're only thinking about themselves for now, them as a pair, and they're just going to do their level best in semis, that's it.
The standard of the competition this tournament really has gone up now that it's a God Grand Prix event.
So standard untuk semifinals ni dah atas dah diorang punya aras tu. So cadangan apa, macam mana nanti?
Saya pun try saya punya best lah untuk kita, saya sama Hoon lah. So, ini semifinal saya juga pun ada prepare untuk nak lawan sama dia lah. Dia orang pun juga buat juga lah itu Indonesian pair.
So the Indonesian pair is quite strong as well, and because it's a Grand Prix and whatnot, so I think they reckon they're just going to do their level best as a pair.
Confident?
Confident?
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, it wasn't the most convincing, yes, but confident nonetheless. And this is the pair they face. You can see Fajar Alfian is nearest to us, 19 years of age. And as you see, they're ranked 61, this pair, but they've won the USM Leaning International just a couple of weeks ago. They won the Austrian Open in February as well. In between them, first round losses in Germany, in Japan and in Vietnam. But normally if they progress, they seem to progress all the way to victory. M.R. Ardianto, his partner, both 19 years of age, so a pretty young pair, obviously with some success early on. Their confidence must be pretty high.
Yeah, like I said, they've been playing well already.
Ladies
this week,
and
they're both youngsters, and I think for the future of Indonesian doubles, it looks good.
Muhammad Rian Arianto, Indonesia. On my left, Hoon Tien Hao, Lim Kim Hwa, Malaysia. Fajar Alfian to serve to Lim Kim Hwa.
17-13.
Level.
So
play.
Men's doubles semi-final, a tough one to really know, really. Got a young Indonesian pair up against an experienced Malaysian pair, but inexperienced in terms of playing together.
Yeah, absolutely. It's both Kim Hwa Lim has been around a while, and Tien Hao Hoon even longer.
Service fault calls.
Service
over.
Racket shaft needs to be pointing down at the moment of contact.
Never a good start to the day, is it?
No.
First serve is given as a fault. Just both going for the same shuttle, both leaving it for one another. It's a big step this for Hoon and for Lim. They've just recently quit the National Association in Malaysia, of course. Obviously, Morten Frost has just become their head man. So they decided to go on their own. They've got some good financial backing, just announced in the last week, some sponsors have got on board. And they were saying after you heard them talking to Stephen there, but they were saying to some of the press station editors, this is positive, you know. Yeah. Guys that have backed us to really try and pay them back.
Yeah, well, I mean, it's always nice to see the guys that are going to support, I guess, players who aren't in the national setups to continue their badminton careers. I think we see a lot of times two players that maybe asked to stop too soon, or when they're still not off of themselves and off of the game.
Yeah, interesting though to quit you know, it was their choice really. They just felt they weren't progressing in the way they wanted to do, by their performances weren't improving. So step out, try something fresh and new.
Yeah, I guess if it doesn't work, maybe try and fix it, but simply. But yeah, it is a brave move to step away from your national team when you're looked after and you're funded and have a lot of things taken care of. There's a lot of things that then you have to sort out off your own back. But if they've got the sponsors on board that'll do it for them, that's really, really good.
Yeah, a lot expected of Alfian and Ardianto. Indonesian pair, that's really well placed out of Ardianto's reach.
3-4.
Hoon Tien Hau, who serving, he represented Malaysia for a decade, so he's been in the national setup before. He left early this year for quite a long time. We've had some terrific men's doubles pairs in Indonesia, haven't they, over the years?
Yeah, they certainly have. They just seem to keep producing them. I think these guys could be one to watch for a number of years. Certainly got good skills.
Well, Alfian here, he played in a club match recently with Lee Yongdae. And
not a bad partner.
Yeah, and well, Lee Yongdae said he could, this kid, become one of the greatest men's double players. He just needs maybe to increase his strength a bit, Lee Yongdae. He was very impressed playing alongside
him.
And of course, Ardianto, his partner, well, he's won silver medal at last year's World Juniors in mixed doubles. So they've got, you know, they've got some pedigree. They've obviously got plenty of talent. And to get the backing of someone like Lee Yongdae, that must give you a real boost.
Well, I guess one thing they do have, that's the hallmark of all the great men's doubles pairs, is superb defense.
And you're seeing from them, and I think particularly from them, is some great movement.
Yeah.
We saw that with the Chinese women's doubles in the last bit. They're getting around the court, reading the situation so well.
Yeah, they have this. I mean, when they lost the first set against the Danish boys in the second round, and then also against Ruud Bosch and Huang Fujui from Netherlands and Chinese Taipei last night. But they have this other second game plan that just basically revolves around getting the lift and attacking down the side of the court, and they close down the net and that same side, and it's really difficult to get it cross court when you smash down there, and they just take the pace out of the shuttle, and really there's not a lot that people can do about it. So if they do that well today, it'll be interesting to see how the Malaysians counter it, because I haven't seen anybody able to do it yet.
That line in the corner was close to going out.
Over. 8-5.
Yeah, he's done that a couple of times now.
Over. 6-8.
And their opponents, Huang Kei-Xing from China and Xing Si-Wei from China.
over. 7-9. Lim.
Just the early part of this match, and I have to say the Indonesians slightly on top, but Asian pair trying to stick with their chance, can't they? Here. Not going to be easy for them, that's for sure.
7.
Tucked away anyway by Lim.
6-8.
Crowd enjoyed it though.
10.
Yeah, I enjoyed it too.
Once again. Oops.
Play.
Good flicks from Hoon, and Lim's aggression tightens things up again.
9-10. Over 11-10.
Decent start, isn't it, to this semi-final? Indonesia with the fragile advantage, though, 11 points to 10.
Yeah, it's been an interesting first 11 points. Both sides have been quite happy to give away the attack and defend a little bit and try and counter that way. There's not a lot of battles for the net in the flat game. And the first three have been pretty evenly contested as well, so it's like a number of other matches we've seen today, it's just warming up, basically.
Court 1, 20 seconds. Court 1, 20 seconds.
Smash there from M.R.Ardianto.
12-10.
Straight down the middle to claim a well-worked point from the Indonesians.
No! 6 over. 11-12.
Down. That's a slip
it's
by
over. Him. 13-11.
Great drop shot that though. So far in front of the service line, it makes it that much more difficult.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, the Bina Kruma, the Marta Putra, Indonesia, Marcus Kudo, Indonesia. On my left, Jesse Wayne,
Marcus Kudo. Too long that from Hoon.
14-11.
play.
Yeah, a couple of three gamers last couple of rounds for the Indonesian pair. It took three 14. Games for Lim and Hoon to come through against Lee and Liu in the quarterfinals as well. So both pairs used to going the distance this week so far in Auckland. Well played.
Six over.
Yeah, really 15, good stuff from the Indonesian pair.
12.
Just keeping the variety in their attacks as well. Hard, hard, soft, and so fun, so hard to come forward and relift.
Lim, ready. Ready.
Now, yeah, well, serve from Ardianto, and Lim Kim Wan wasn't ready. Racket was up. Was ready for that one though, wasn't he?
Certainly Sona was.
13, 15.
But the luck there going the way of the Malaysians.
15.
4-1. Service over.
Great third shot there from Hoon.
Yeah, and he's found that 15, space, hasn't he, in that side 4. Of the court a few times in this match. Not easy to do, is it?
No, not at all.
5-2.
Yeah, he's very, very skillful and he's got a great hand. He's able to, his racket speed is tremendous.
Thank you.
Six, two.
So evenly 15. Poised at 15 all in the first. Definite boy from the Malaysians that looks at quite a lot.
Never
a great time to put a return of serve in the net, but 15-16, it's not what you're after.
Yeah, you say he's got good wrist, good hands, but just trying to get too subtle with that one. Hoon. Oh, he shouldn't have left that. That was a big misjudgment from Lim.
18-15.
A couple of errors at the wrong time. Disguise, great deception.
19-10-15.
11-4 interval. So it's the youngsters from Indonesia with a 4-point run. Make that 5.
20.
Decisive run, it game seems, points. As well in this opening game. 5 15. Game points now.
Oh,
But a real confidence about the way these teenage Indonesian duo saw through that first game. Fajar Alfian and Muhammad Rian Ardianto. Very convincing in the end. 21 points to 15.
Yeah, well, I mean, until 15-all, it was a pretty evenly fought contest, and then just a couple of errors from the Malaysians gave the Indonesian boys some momentum, and once they get a bit of confidence, they really seem to ride on it. And ran away with that first game, 21-15.
We've seen from them, as you mentioned yesterday and other days, that they have had a tendency to let the opposition in. I mean, I suppose it's been a good thing that they've done that and seen it through. Maybe it's been a learning curve for them, that maybe this time they can stay fully focused, get the job done quicker today.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, in the both first sets I've seen them play, in the quarterfinals and the last 16, they came out hard and fast in the first set, and it just didn't work for them. They gave the opponents too much speed, and it was much easier for them to be controlled rather than do the controlling. Whereas today they seem to have started how they finished and there are other matches with it, taking a little bit more pace out of the shuttle, just put it down and ask the Malaysians to create something, and they haven't been able to do so far.
Well, quarterfinal at the China Masters, semi-finals here at the New Zealand Open. It's been progress in their early partnership for Hoon and Lim. But is this as far as they go? Service over 7-16. So the 19-year-olds Fajar Alfian and Muhammad Rian Ardianto, hoping just to pick up where they left off. A little bit of work on Lim Kim Hwa's hand there, but that's standard, isn't it? When you're holding a racket for that long, you're going to get these kind of problems.
Yeah, it looks to be like a possible diving, I guess you'd call it an injury, but maybe that's a bit of a heavy term for a scratch, but he's certainly not afraid to throw himself about.
Lim.
Oh, needs a bit more attention for it.
Must have been a little bit of blood.
Yeah.
18-7.
Shemlim Kamwan won the Malaysian Open last year. You thought that was going to be a partnership that blossomed, but obviously wasn't to be.
It seems to be a bit of almost a theme of world badminton at the moment, that these men's doubles and particularly men's doubles partnerships just keep changing.
Yeah, I suppose now you've got to kind of, you know, it's the Olympics qualification starting now. You've kind of got to find who your partner is and stick with them if you want to have a chance of being in Rio.
Yeah, exactly. But I mean, that's the thing that should start a few years ago. It's well read.
Pretty good rally, isn't it, to start the second game?
Over. One. Love.
And a positive one for the Malaysians.
Lim.
Not towards them.
They're talking about the celebration, yeah?
Yeah. You have to make sure you keep that celebration to yourself. And
not direct it at your guys at the other end.
Pretty much.
I don't know. I quite like to see a bit of that, don't you?
Yeah.
Sober.
Wouldn't want to receive it, but
no.
You want to see a bit of passion out
yeah,
there.
Yeah, absolutely. It's always good to see a bit of emotion. It's all part of the game.
Second game.
It's that's one area where those Indonesian boys are really, really skillful around the net.
Well, the winner of this match takes on Huang Kaixing or Jingxi Wei of China. Likely they're playing another Indonesian pair, Marcus Kido, in action against, again, alongside Putra. But Chinese pair took the opening set in that men's double quite comfortably. So Huang and Zheng, the likely opponents for the winner here.
Did enough there with the shot that broke the string to win the rally. Give
three,
them.
Two.
Yeah, we've seen a few matches today, haven't we, where someone's giving away a few years since Yao, 10 years older than both his Indonesian opponents. Brilliantly, didn't they?
Yeah, terrific defense from the Malaysians in that rally. I'd like to see a little more variety in the attack from the Indonesians. It's all very hard. And while they can smash hard, it's all straight to Hoon's racket. And he's skilled enough to control that. That's better.
Yeah, you just can't go blast, 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 can you, really? Otherwise, your opponent knows what's coming.
Absolutely, and especially against a guy like Hoon.
Excellent rally, super skills, excellent winner from Hoon Tien Hao.
Yeah, terrific skills on display from both sides there.
5-3.
Yeah, that's what you mean by mixing it up, don't you, really?
Yep, that's exactly it. Tennis serve from F.Alfian setting up that one.
Correction. 4-5.
That's more like it.
Yeah, brilliantly done by Ardianto. Brings it back level in this
service
second
over
game.
11-7 interval. Play. Boom. Ready. Ah. 6-5.
Yeah, well worked again by the Indonesians. I spotted that Hoon wasn't going to hit that one with full power on, or able to move forward and
11, seven,
counter it effectively. Five.
Well, they're finding the angles,
seven,
they're finding the
five,
right shots to play as well. Panic early on here from Alfian and Ardianto now easing ahead in this second game.
You're playing with fire a bit when you're playing these little
six,
floating chip shots into the midcourt, but my defense is certainly good enough to get them back. I think especially with these Malaysians when they've just won three or four easy points, playing a big court, and moving them around to the extremes, why change and make it tight again?
13.
That was brilliant skills from him, and it just shows you what he can do. Nonchalantly done as well, wasn't it?
It was, it really was. When it came back, it was in all sorts of trouble, but with that much confidence.
Players.
Impossible to read that.
Yeah.
Too much delay. Ready to play. Play.
Well, quite clear from our umpire there, Richard Bramley. Get on with it.
Oh!
11, 13.
It's over. 8, 7. Play.
Alfian serving there is to say, come on, boys, let's get on with it. Yeah. Can you hear the umpire?
Yeah, as you do when he's working in your favour.
That's in.
Perfect.
That's in.
Right on the line.
9-7.
The agony of knowing it's going to drop in as well. Why didn't I play? Straight through them from Ardianto.
10.
Yes, again, seven. Three or four times he's had some success with it. Smash down the middle. He found the open space.
15, they look like they've got the weapons, don't they, this Indonesian pair?
Yeah, they certainly do. They've really got a lot of good things going.
Yeah,
there's
that.
A prime example of another
11,
one.
7,
nice 11, variety.
13. And we've seen some great shots, haven't we, from Huntini Tiao, and particularly at the start of this second game. But
yeah,
just the overall consistency and the quality has come from the Indonesians.
Yeah, absolutely. I think now they're tactically been a bit better for the second half of that 11-point spell. At the start, they were trying to play a lot of shuttles in the middle of the court and trying to engage them in the Malaysians in the flat rallies, and it just wasn't working so well. It's better to make the court bigger, move them around, drag them to one side, play the shuttle the other, create the space, and then they play the shuttle into it and take the offense from that.
Court 1, 20 seconds. Court 1, 20 seconds. Wait, please. Court.
Now the king to get on with the umpire, saying you have to wait the allotted 2 minutes.
11, 7.
Service over.
Play.
18, 15.
Definitely come on, Lim.
8, 11.
if there's one area that the Indonesians do leave a little bit of space, it's in that forehand corner. And the front, they're very quick to cover the flat cross when the shuttle's on that side of the court, but there is some space where Khim Wah-Lim blocked that smash before. Just there. Slight lost moment of concentration there, maybe.
Yeah, now or never really, though, isn't it, for the Malaysians? They are to try and emerge out of this semi-final. Clash of rackets there between Hoon and Lim.
I think Khim Wah-Lim has a broken spring, which is why he wanted to rush to the net, but it left Hoon with plenty of work to do.
12-9.
So Justin, is it the winner of this Malaysia-Indonesian clash will face Huang and Zheng from China in tomorrow's final?
Yeah, gonna have to face the Asian junior champions. Another good young talented pair. If it is the Indonesians, again, it's going to be a final of the future, if you like.
It is, yeah.
Oh.
What a shame. F.Alfian netting. F.Alfian done so well.
11, 12.
Yeah, some great skills on display in that rally again.
No more.
A bit of momentum change here, I think.
12. All.
Well, five of the last 6 points have gone to Hoon and Lim. Wasn't going to miss that one.
No.
It's over. 13-12.
Just a slight hesitancy can be fatal, can't it?
Yeah, as soon as you hesitate, that's it. The chance is gone. One of the dangers of playing against a left-hander, of course. Yeah, that's that space I was talking about before.
Just can't get ahead, can they?
No.
It's over.
Good and limp in this match, in any
14,
of the games.
13.
Yeah, big, powerful smash from Ardianto doing the damage that time.
So it's over. 14, all.
Well, they're ahead now.
15.
Remember, it was 15-all in that opening game. We all know went on after that. Well, they have a 15-14 lead now, Hoon and Lim. To that did Ardianto.
So
I don't think maybe 15. His opponents thought he was going to get it back.
No, it's great coverage from his partner, and then, yeah, great court coverage to retrieve that one.
So it is 15-all.
So it is. Let's see if they can do it again.
Thank you.
Him wanted to have some water as well. Umpires being very strict here.
15.
Yeah, he's not giving the players any leeway at all. Well worked first 16. Three from Alfian there to create that 15. Attack.
And Ardianto's power again. It's proving too much.
There's one of six.
Oh! Over. 16-4.
Wonder, we haven't really, have we, seen 17. All day, I don't think, in any of the matches, actually,
16.
Any of that real late in the game tension, you know, nothing's really been that close, and here we are at 17-16. I wonder whether we're going to see a bit of that here.
Celebration.
Indeed, it proved to be.
Again, Ardianto's power from the back line.
18, 16.
Really causing problems for Lim Khim Wah, especially.
Players ready.
Well, both pairs getting some good support from the crowd around us. And it's the Indonesians who are cheering loudest
19,
right now.
16.
Because Alfian and Ardianto are close to a final here in New Zealand.
Exquisite pickup. Dive from Khim Wah Lim, not enough. So that leaves us with the Indonesians with a set and 3-point lead at 19-16. Hoon not happy with the mopping.
Yeah, he's still not satisfied. Look at him.
Having a laugh about it, I think. But
19-16. Lim.
Defense from Alfian.
Yeah, match points have arrived.
20. Match point. 16.
Off the head of Ardianto.
17. 20.
One down, three to go. to the 18, lights there from Fajar Alfin. Are through to the final of the New Zealand Open. They both may only be 19 years of age, but they showed some great maturity in that match, wrapping it up in fine style in straight games.
Yeah, fantastic performance from the Indonesian boys. You wouldn't know how young they were by the way they played this afternoon. It was clinical, it was clever. And they just proved to be the superior pair.
Confirmation of the scoreline then. 21-15, 21-18.
Match won by Fajar Alfian, Muhammad Rian Ayanto. 21-15, 21-18.
Yeah, terrific performance from the Indonesian pair, and it's their third final of the year. Maybe it's going to be their third victory of the year. They're going to take on the Asian junior champions Huang Kaixiang and Zheng Siwei in tomorrow's final. That should be an interesting match, shouldn't it? So as the players make their way off court, most of the spectators here making their way home. Been a good day's entertainment, hasn't it? Any one of the matches, though, going to three games on this court. Couple did on the other court, though, as well. And the finals tomorrow, well, should be some great matches there. But in this men's doubles match that we've just seen, Fajar Alfian and Muhammad Rian Ardianto showed that they're going to be a real prospect, aren't they, over the coming years. 21-15, 21-18, their victory. And I think we can hear from them now.
Muhammad Fajar, congratulations. Tidy game. Muhammad strong from the backcourt tonight.
Muhammad, bagus sekali kamu dari belakang. Sangat kuat dari belakang.
Ya, kenapa?
Enggak, kamu dari belakang katanya bagus, kuat.
Iya.
Game-nya ketat.
Iya. Yeah. Jadi kita persiapannya ya lebih persiapan semes-semes ya. Mungkin kekuatannya, karena kan sana kan defense-nya biasanya Malaysia-nya bagus. Okay. Jadi harus siap lebih capek.
They actually prepared very well because they knew that the Malaysian were very strong in defense. So they actually just keep trying their best and then keep smashing.
You seem to make a habit of making finals. I think this is final number three this year, if I'm correct?
Ini kamu final yang nomor tiga tahun ini? Tahun ini?
Ya.
Yeah, final number three. That's correct.
Empat ya?
Empat. Number four.
Number four. Well, what's the key to this successful combination, Fajar?
Kira-kira kuncinya apa di? Kamu punya kombinasi ini kuncinya apa kira-kira?
Kuncinya, saya berusaha bermain kompak, jaga komunikasi yang lebih baik aja.
They communicate on the field and they actually try to play together. Keep it stick. Yeah. Together.
Gentlemen, congratulations. You're in the final of the Skycity New Zealand Open.
Thank you.
Yeah, their fourth final in a year, but their third final of this year. But, well, whatever the case may be, they are through to tomorrow's final. Here's our results then from on court. And, well, as you can see in the first four matches, dominated by the Chinese mixed doubles to start with. It was a good day for Shea, who we saw later winning the women's doubles as well, alongside Ook, Soroff, Marcus Kido, and Bernadette, the brother-sister combination. He, Bing Zhao, so impressive, wasn't she, the 18-year-old. Bunsuk Pansana showed some resistance to Chao Bin, but in the end, the Chinese player came through against the veteran in three games. It was very comfortable for Shea and Zhong in the women's doubles, and then just now, in the men's doubles, the 19-year-olds Alfian and Ardianto seeing the job done. Well, I think you agree it's been a very enjoyable day's play here in the North Shore Centre in Auckland. And five terrific finals in prospect for tomorrow as well. This was the match that concluded our viewing here. in the semi-finals, and we have to say you can only be impressed by the 19-year-olds, the way that Fajar Alfian and Mohammed Rian Ardianto managed to get the job done. Some nice skills at times, wasn't there, from the Malaysian pair. Hunti Hiao showing what he can do, but as in many of the previous games, once Alfian and Ardianto got themselves in front, they were hard to claw back. Ah! Ah! 21-15, 21-18, the winning score, and through to another final. So tomorrow's finals, who's going to come away with those titles? It should be some interesting matchups, shouldn't it? We really look forward to your company then for the final day of the Skycity New Zealand Open. But for now, from Oliver Layden-Davis and myself, Richard Kaufman, bye-bye for now.